National Anthem at the beginning of the women's game, and they will not play it again at the men's game, but they do it twice here tonight. So my apologies for the delay there, but obviously for good cause. Starting lineups being unveiled as we speak, but a big ball game here in conference play. Right now the standings in the conference stand like this. Texas Southern's 10-1. In first place, Alcorn State 9-2. So that's who the Golden Lions are about to take on here. Southern 7-5. The Golden Lions just one game behind them. Southern's in third place at 7-5. And then there's a three-way tie for fourth place right now with Jackson State, Alabama State, and your Golden Lions of UAPB, all 6-6, tied for that fourth spot. Now remember, all the top four teams will host the first round game on their home floor this year in conference play. So lots at stake here tonight. The Golden Lions with the win and a Southern loss here tonight. The Golden Lions could be in third place at the end of the night, or even if they were to lose this game, they could still potentially be tied for fourth place. So still a lot to be talked about as far as the standings and the seedings and things of that nature, but a lot of basketball yet to be played. But nevertheless, a big game here tonight for the Golden Lions. We are set. Alcorn State in their road purple and gold, UAPB in their home whites with the black and gold trim. Tipping tonight for Alcorn State, DeAndre Davis, 6'8", senior forward out of Spotsylvania, Virginia. The Golden Lions a little late coming out to the circle, but Lynch, Steen, Barry, Tolliver, and Robinson, the starting five for UAPB, and Devin Barry will be tipping for the Golden Lions. We are set and ready to go for this 8-16 tip-off, a late one here tonight. It should be a good one. UAPB Alcorn State underway. Chasing down the opening tip is Giovanni Robinson. Lynch out of Tolliver. Tolliver quiet the last game. He come off of a combined 13 threes made in his last two. Backdoor lob and jam. Are you kidding me? One-handed rock the cradle. Smashing it home is Trent Steen. The backdoor lob to start the game and smashes it down. The 2-0 Golden Lion lead. Now that's how you start a game. Underneath, Davis, the two for Alcorn. We're tied at two. I said this one should be a good one. If that's any indication, we are in for a treat. Throw it right side to Robinson. Cross court to Tolliver. Top of the key to Lynch. Steen right at the foul line. They try to collapse on him. Back out Lynch for three. Got it. Jaquan Lynch hits the three, and the Golden Lions off to a fast start lead, 5-2, 1 minute in. Here's the big man, Vance. He had a big ball game against UAPB in Alcorn last month. Three-point shot in the corner will not go for Doolin. UAPB's got it. They want to push the other way. Doolin knocks it away for Alcorn. Mosby's got it. Right side to Vance. Steen tried to take it from him, but going to get Steen with a foul. He thought he just knocked it out of bounds, but he gets the cheap foul. Marquise Vance, 6'7", 265 pounds senior for Alcorn State. Got that big football body. Left side. Dump it off down low. Davis traveled, I believe. Both officials talking it over. I had a travel, and that's what it is. I'm not sure if they were going to call a foul. One official may have had a foul that the backside official had to travel. had a better look at it. DeAndre Davis didn't like the call. Was telling the official that the other official had the foul and that should have overridden the travel. Nice pass, Perry underneath, two-handed slam, throws it down. Making it look easy. 7-2. A lot of rim shaking going on here in the first 2 minutes for the Golden Lions, up by 5. 3-point shot up by Patterson, no good. Here's Tolliver, he'll push it ahead. The Golden Lions up 5 early. Need some help. Perry, top of the key, now to Lynch. Takes his time here on the right wing, looks for a screen from Perry, gets it. Left side to Robinson, now to Steen. Step back, 15-footer, left side, no good. Rebound, quickly. Mosby goes all the way, and he's fouled. Stops the clock at 17:29 to play. Early first half. A.J. Mosby. Junior out of Cartersville, Georgia. He'll toe the line here. Called that foul on Jaquan Lynch. His first, team foul number 2 on UAPB as Mosby makes the first free throw. Southpaw makes them both. Some pressure here by the Braves. Light pressure, ball tipped. Get it to Robinson on the left wing. Now Lynch will come out high, set it up. Right side, Tolliver back to Lynch. Now to Robinson, 15 to shoot. Lynch wide open three and hits. Nothing but net, yes sir. Jaquan Lynch, he's got 6, 2 triples. The Golden Lions lead by 6, 10-4. Mosby will hold it out high. Now top of the key, Patterson. They work it on the baseline to Davis. They trap him, he needs some help. Cross court pass. Doolin kicks it out. Patterson, the little floater goes with the shot clock winding down. 10-6. First 2 for Patterson. 16:25 to play. Early first half, Golden Lions with the ball up 4. Left side, Lynch, open 3, hits another. He is red hot to start the game. 3 for 3 from downtown, Lynch on fire. 13-6. As the Golden Lions, streaky at times from 3, but when they're hot, they are real hot. And they're hot early on here. 7-point lead for the Golden Lions, and Lynch has 9 already. Vance, he'll take a long 3, right wing, no good. Rebound, Steen, he was undercut by his own man, Barry, and threw it away. Mosby open 3, no good. Battle for the rebound, Lynch has it. Right side, now works it left side to Tolliver. Here's Tolliver, he'll take the long 3, off to the left, no good. McDice up off the bench early here. He'll come in at the next dead ball. Davis missed it inside. Barry with the rebound. He kind of did a reverse move. May have got away with a little travel there, but missed the shot nevertheless. 13-6, UAPB by 7. 5 minutes in here. Here's Lynch. Nice drop off pass to Steen from 10, no good. Tipped out on the rebound. Lynch again for 3. Right side is good. Jaquan Lynch has the student section fired up, and now one of the players for Alcorn having words with one of the students in the crowd, and they actually kind of went face to face there for a second. 16-6. We got a 10-point lead for UAPB, and it is hot and hopping and popping here in the Hyper tonight. You can feel it in the air. 16-6. One of the Alcorn players is pointing towards the UAPB student section with the official. He is not letting it go. That's Denzel Doolin, who has took exception to something that happened. 14:34 to play, a media timeout. UAPB leads 16-6. And Jaquan Lynch is on another planet right now called Splash City. Wow. He is 4-for-5 from downtown in the first 5-plus minutes of the game. Great atmosphere in here tonight. Looks like they got things settled down. Looks like they got things settled down as it was getting a little chippy over there. One of the security guards came over, had a word with the student section. And Doolin didn't like something. And anyway, I believe it's all passed now. They'll inbound it here, Southern. Down 10, now make it 7 as Mosby hits the 3. 16-9, 14:25 to play first half. Lynch, actually 4-for-4, I slided him a miss. He's 4-for-4 from downtown. The long misses, well, actually I gave a miss to Bayless and he hadn't even been in the game yet. So it was Lynch is 4-for-5, they just missed it. Here's Lynch, takes another 3, missed this one. How about McNice inside, misses the putback off the rebound. Vance has it now for Alcorn. McNice go up and dunk it, big fella. 16-9, Davis inside, contact, no call. He's not gonna be happy with that. Lynch, left side, Jackson. Got Harper in the game, McDice, you got McKinney. 4 new players along, except for Lynch is the only player, and why not? He was red hot. Nice pass to Jackson, but couldn't handle it from McKinney. A good idea, but the execution was flawed. Golden Lions, biggest lead's been 10 early on here. It's at 7 right now. 13-25 and counting. Alcorn with the ball down 7. As the Golden Lions come out hot to start the game. Right side to Mosby. And they get it to the quick Howard. Howard knocked out of bounds, gonna stay with Alcorn. Howard had a nice game at Alcorn against UAPB earlier. Here on the baseline, the floater goes. Nicely done. That was Mosby. Mosby now with 7 himself. He's got the last 5, 16-11. Trying to dump it down low to McDice. Harper's pass stolen away. They'll work it left side. Kick out from Vance. Howard slipped a little bit. Doolin will take the 3, no good. Harper up high for the board. Here's Jackson, he'll push it ahead. Left side of the floor now. Lynch will come out. Lynch off the bounce to McKinney. Get it to McDice on the left block. To Harper, 15-footer, no good. Knocked out of bounds by McKinney. It'll be Alcorn basketball with 12-12 to play. First half, UAPB leading by 5, 16-11. Here's Vance. Faces the basket, working on McKinney. Blocked by McKinney. Blocking the 6'7" power forward. Here's Jackson down the corner. Lynch for three, rimmed out, no good. Had a good look at it, and it just wouldn't stay down. Trying to get it to Johnson, almost lost it. Vance out of Mosby, his little teardrop goes on the baseline, and Mosby, he's on a 7-0 run by himself. He's got nine, and that 10-point lead has been cut to three. Timeout on the floor. 16-13, 11:34 to play. George Ivory called a timeout, even though the next dead ball would have been next dead ball would have been a media timeout. Basketball, Jackson, McKinney, McDice, Wallace, who just checked in, and Harper in the game. No pressure here by Alcorn. They'll set up in the half court. And on the shot clock, I don't think it ever took off there. Golden Lions 6 of 13 from the field so far, 46%. They actually cooled off after starting off 6 of 10. They've missed their last three. They're 4 of 7 from three-point range. Jaquan Lynch is 4 for 6 himself. As he leads all scores with 12 so far. Alcorn State led by A.J. Mosby with his nine. They are 5 of 12, 42% from the field, 1 of 5 from three-point range. 2 of 2 from the foul line are the Braves. UAPB yet to attempt a free throw. Golden Lions out rebounding Alcorn 10 to 5 so far. Here's McDice to Jackson, 10 to shoot. Harper. Back to Jackson, he'll take the three. Rimmed out, no good. Battle for the rebound, Vance has it. Seven unanswered here for Alcorn, and they have the basketball down three. Nice steal here, Trevon Harper to McKinney. McKinney may take it all the way. Kick out in the corner, Charles Jackson for three. Yes, sir. Jackson with the big corner pocket, three ball. 19-13, UAPB back up six, snaps a 7-0 run. Left side. Howard, now to Doolin, spinning and a foul call. 10:25 to play, first half. McKinney's going to get the foul, his first, team foul number three. No fouls yet to be called on Alcorn. We're almost 10 minutes into the game. It's been a common theme the last few games for UAPB. Tyler Carter's checked in for the first time. Dumps it down low, and Davis hits the deck hard as he slams into Steen. And they're going to get the foul on Steen, I believe. Or they're going to get Harper, rather, his first, team foul number four. Two foul shots coming up here for DeAndre Davis. First shot is good for Davis, makes it 19-14. Bayless checks in for the first time for UAPB, as Harper will check out. Davis makes both free throws. A little over 10 to play first half, almost a turnover here, and it is stolen. A nice play by Howard on the steal, and then Mosby gets a little one-hander to go from 10 feet out, and just like that, it's a two-point game. 11 for Mosby so far to lead Alcorn State. And the sixth turnover for UAPB. Alcorn with just one turnover. Wallace on the left wing, works it back top of the circle, right side. Jackson spots up for three, no good. Offensive rebound, Bayless, then he gets it blocked, gets it back again. Now set it up with Jackson out high on the left wing, now to Wallace. Back to McKinney, work it to Jackson on the left wing again. Here's McKinney, right side. Bayless, the drive and the foul. First foul of the game on Alcorn at the 9:14 mark here of the first half. And it's going to be called on Maurice Howard. Here's Jackson. Now to Steen on the right block. Strong move in the lane. Steen is going to be fouled by Davis, I believe. Oh, instead they're going to get Carter. Freshman from Houston, Texas. Out of Steinbrenner High School. Carter only saw action in the final minute of the game against UAPB at Alcorn. He actually hit a three late in that game. It's loose basketball, and Wallace comes away with it to Steen. Kick out behind the back dribble inside. Bayless, score it. Tough basket for Bayless. Want to see more of that out of him. Maybe pound for pound the best athlete on this team. That's just my opinion. But this kid, there's sky's the limit. For Deshaun Bayless, athletic ability. And a foul call, getting a little chippy there. Bayless and DeAndre Davis. Foul is on Bayless, his first team foul, number five. Reginald Johnson hits the wide open three, little set shot. Smooth as butter. 21-20, it's a one-point game. The Golden Lions lead down to just one. Nice pass, big dunk. Steen crushes it home off the McKinney assist. Steen with four, both of them have been dunks. An alley-oop dunk in the first 30 seconds of the game, and then that one right there. Pull up for Davis, no good. Rebound, nice block out there by Wallace. Kicks it ahead to Jackson. UAPB with the ball up three. Jackson back to McKinney, wants to go baseline with it. Kicks it in the corner. Wallace, corner three, a little too strong, no good. Long rebound to Steen. Then got it taken away by Howard. Howard, pull up, no good. Battle for the rebound, Steen's got it. Back and forth we go, here's Bayless. He'll slow it down. 7:40 to play, first half. 23-20, UAPB by three in the basketball. McKinney off the bounce. Jackson for three, rimmed out, no good. Look at Bayless, almost got an awesome putback, but it rimmed out on him. But that's some of that ability I was talking about. Kick out, Carter, top of the key. Davis, strong drive, whistle, a foul called. His body's hit the floor, and This could be number two on Steen as Davis is still slow to get up, holding that left thigh area. Gonna have a media timeout here with 7:15 to play. First half, UAPB 23, Alcorn State 20. And a good first half. Been an exciting first half. The University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff Athletics would like to thank the following sponsors as we look at Trent Steen's dunk here on the replay. Sponsors for Gold Lions Athletics, MK Distributors, Trotter Ford Lincoln, Reliance Bank, Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Sissy's Log Cabin, Russell Athletic, Brown Funeral Home, and Energy. Davis hits the first as we resume play here. Alcorn now 5 for 5. Now 6 of 6 from the foul line. Davis is 3 for 3 and Mosby's 3 for 3 from the line. Cuts it to a 1-point game, 23-22, just over 7 to play before halftime. Another issue with the clock. UAPB 9 of 21, 43% from the field, 5 of 11, 46% from three-point range. Yet to attempt a free throw have the Golden Lions. Alcorn State 7 of 16, 44% from the field, 2 of 6 from three-point range. And they're 6 of 6 from the foul line. Lynch still the leading scorer with 12 for UAPB, hitting 4 threes early in the game. A.J. Mosby now with 12 for Alcorn State. Here's Harper, top of the key. Robinson, now to Lynch. He'll take the shot right side, and it's good, and another three. Just in case you forgot about me, Mr. Lynch splashes in another one. His fifth first half three, he's got 15. 26-22. Looks like he's the big man on campus tonight. And Reginald Johnson muscles one in off the glass. Another big football body for this Brave team. He's 6'5", 250. Kick out, Robinson will take the open three, air ball. 26-24, Alcorn State down two with the basketball. Kick out to Mosby. Left side to Vance. He will shoot it from there if left open. Patterson kick out Mosby down low. Johnson's 10-footer goes and we're tied at 26. Reginald Johnson, he's got 7. 5:45 to play first half. Here's McKinney. Pull up from 15 is good. Kennedy McKinney. His first two, and the Golden Lions back up by a deuce. Mosby, left side to Patterson. Back to Doolin, now to Johnson. Off the bounce, stripped, stolen. McKinney. Gold Lions with numbers. Lynch pulls up for three, no good. Harper goes over Bayless for the dunk. He didn't realize it, I don't believe, as both of them were in position there to have a putback basket, but he missed the dunk as he was going over his own man. Vance for three, got it. Told you the big man can stroke it. He's got a soft touch. He has got a soft touch from three, and he hits a big three there to put Alcorn up by one, 29-28. So Alcorn battles back from down 10 early to take a one-point lead. Foul called, 4:33 left. Barry, Steen, and Tolliver check in as Harper, Bayless, and McKinney are out. Inbound it to Steen. Goes up for the shot in the lane while my man LaRon Marbley is still with some announcements. They inbound it quickly and the Golden Lions get the bucket. Don't see that very often. Maybe it brought us some good luck. 30-29. 1 point lead, UAPB. Vance off the glass, no good. Barry the rebound. Kick out, Robinson spots up for three, no good. Just been off a little bit. Vance, right side, Patterson, passes up the three, knifes his way in the lane, dishes it off to Doolin off the glass and good. 31-30. Alcorn State by one, 3:40 to play. Late first half. Here's Robinson gonna go baseline with it, up and under gets the layup. Nice athletic play by Giovanni Robinson. His first two, and that puts the Golden Lions back up a point. 32-31. Right side to Doolin. Back to Howard. Howard, out of Vance, five to shoot. Vance rise and fire and hits. The big man, two in a row from that left wing. Yeah, 6'7", 265, and can shoot like that. 34-32, Alcorn by two. Here's Lynch, why not? Got it. Jaquan Lynch stays hot. His sixth three of the first half, he's got 18. And the Golden Lions back up by one. Riding the shoulders of Jaquan Lynch here in the first half. He's got 18 of the 35. Left side to Patterson, driving baseline. Kicks it back to the big fella. Passes up the three, Howard, an air ball. Steen, rocket pass ahead to Tolliver, trying to save it. He does so. Robinson, strong drive. No foul called on the contact. George Ivory not happy. Now, I don't blame him. Got to be a foul in there somewhere. A steal by UAPB. Robinson, they have number. Steen to Berry with the one-handed smash. Numbers, numbers, numbers. Three-on-one break, and the Golden Lions crush home the transition basket with 90 seconds left before halftime to take a three-point lead, 37-34. Vance again, he's filling it, misses this time. Rebound UAPB, that will push it again. Robinson wants to go all the way, this time he gets it to go. Timeout called by Alcorn State. UAPB on a run after they were down by two, quickly up five, a 7-0 spurt here for George Ivory's Golden Lions with 1:09 to play before halftime. They are getting up and down the floor here in the first half. Take another look there, good shot by Ariana Carmichael underneath the basket. On that three-on-one break, That's perfect ball movement there. Robinson, I believe McKinney. There I am. What's up, guys? The infinity camera shot where it goes into the monitor and it just kind of keeps going and keeps going. ...39-34 UAPB by five. Exciting first half of action. As we are just a buck 09 away, 109 from halftime. UAPB led by as many as 10. Alcorn battled back to take a 2-point lead. And the Golden Lions back up by five on a 7-0 run here. Howard, Lynch, Robinson, Barry, and Tolliver, the five on the floor for the Golden Lions. Here's Howard, now to Mosby, left side. Back to Patterson, top of the key. Mosby, kick out. Johnson, gonna go in the lane. May have got away with a walk, missed it. Davis, the offensive rebound, stick back in, one, the foul on Barry. Big offensive board. That's the first offensive rebound for Alcorn in the game. UAPB's got eight of them. On the Golden Lions out rebounding Alcorn State 20-12 here in the first half. Davis at the line. He's got 7 points. He's 3-for-3 from the foul stripe. Alcorn 6-of-6 as a team. UAPB yet to attempt a free throw. Only 3 fouls have been called on Alcorn the entire first half. 7 against UAPB. And he makes the free throw to cut it to a 2-point game. Both teams shooting well from the field. UAPB at 49%, 16 of 33, including 7 of 16 from 3-point line. And Alcorn at 50%, 12 of 24. They're 4 for 10 from the 3-point line. So a pretty efficient offensive half here for both teams. 3 on the shot clock. Robinson's got to get it off. Hits the side of the backboard and a shot clock violation. And Robinson just bent off on his shot tonight. A better shooter than he has showed. 39-37. Now holding for the final shot, Alcorn trying to tie or take the lead into halftime. Howard stripped. Oh, and they call a very late foul here. The Golden Lions thought they had a steal. They were ready to go the other way with it with 2 seconds left. And a delayed foul was called. Going to be called on Wallace. And a 1-and-1 here, unless they're going to say he was in the act of shooting, I guess. First shot is good. 1.9 seconds left. Got them both, we're tied. Ahead, stolen by Howard. Half court shot, no good off the glass. And we are at halftime. 39-39. Golden Lions got off to a red hot start. Alcorn came back, end up tying it at halftime, 39 all. We'll take a break, have the second half coming up for you in just a bit.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, let me have your attention, please, directed at mid-court, center court. The University of Arkansas Empire Club is proud at this time to salute our student athletes, cheerleaders, and members, not only for excellence in their extracurricular activities, but most importantly, for excellence in the classroom. During the fall of 2016 semester, a total of 119 student athletes distinguished themselves by attaining grade point averages of 3.25 or better, including 31 who made the Chancellor's list with perfect 4.0 GPAs, 58 who made the Dean's list with GPAs of 3.5 to 3.999, and 30 who made the Honor Roll with GPAs of 3.25 to 3.49. Additionally, 10 members of the cheerleading squad and 49 members of our band also distinguished themselves by earning academic honors during the fall of the 2016 semester, including one cheerleader and 5 band members who made perfect 4.0 GPAs. Let's give them all a big round of applause. To salute these student athlete scholars, cheerleaders, and band members at center court are Chancellor Lawrence B. Alexander, along with members of his cabinet. Director of Athletics, Mr. Lonzo Hardy Jr., Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs, Dr. Jacqueline McQuay, Vice Chancellor for Student Affairs, Mr. Elmer Bennett, Chief of Staff, Mrs. Janet Rolls, Vice Chancellor for Finance and Administration, Attorney Carla Martin, and also at Center Court, our Associate Athletics Director, Mrs. Elise Wells Kilmer, and Director of Student Athlete Academic Services, Ms. Kimberly Abbott, also Mr. Ronald McDonald. And now we present to you our academic honorees by affiliation. We ask that you please hold applause until they all have been recognized. Men's basketball is escorted by head coach George Ivory. On the Chancellor's list, with a perfect 4.0 GPA, Cleve Campbell. On the Dean's list, with GPAs 3.50 to 3.99, Jordan McNair. And on the Honors Roll, with GPAs 3.25 to 3.49, Cedric Turner, Christian Robertson, and Richard Williams. And now women's basketball, escorted by head coach Nate Kilburn. On the Chancellor's list, perfect 4.0s, Ashley Daniel and Asia Richardson. On the Dean's list, 3.50 to 3.99, Malik Muhammad, Jasmine Johnson, and Rhea Caesar. And on the Honors Roll, 3.25 to 3.49, Faith O'Hara, Destiny Root, and Kai Richardson. And for baseball, escorted by head coach Carlos James. On the Chancellor's list, a perfect 4.0 GPA, Sergio Esperanza. On the Dean's list, the grade point average is 3.50 to 3.99, Nicholas Watson, Corey Henderson, Tyrus Lopez, Jacob Irwin, Casey Higgins, Bradley Lopez, Alvin O'Brien, Williams Olsen, Killer Hinton, Cole Lewington, Jacob Colombo, Jeremiah Figueroa, and Tim Reynolds. And on the honors roll, 3.25 to 3.49, Jacob Waters, Austin Toto, Antoine Luster, J.B. Seriano, Dontrell Brown, and Jordan Knox. And now for football, ladies and gentlemen, escorted by head coach Monty Coleman. On the Chancellor's list with a 4.0 GPA, Samuel Beavers and Malik Walker. On the Dean's list with GPAs of 3.50 and 3.99, Gabriel Cadomo, Nolan Sorensen, Cameron Willis, Twan Downs, Kyron Lawson, Terry Montgomery, Eric Reed, Kobe McNeil, DeAndre Ridley, Nicholas Stroud, Ryan Williams, and Devin Mitchell. And on the honors roll, 3.25 to 3.49, Blake Connor, Rico Merriweather, Joshua Wallace, Roger Tyler, Trayvon Reagan, Kyle Noel, and Marcus Terrell. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for men's golf, escorted by head coach Roger Tyler. On the Dean's list, Ryan Cloud. And now, ladies and gentlemen, women's cross-country indoor outdoor track, escorted by head coach Christopher McCoy. On the Chancellor's list with a perfect 4.0, Salonika Hunter, DeAndre James, and Ashley Tasher. On the Dean's list, 3.50 to 3.99, Sarita Roach, Kamaya Knight, Sharoya Sims, Sydney Wurtos, and Summer Gilliam. And also men's cross-country indoor and outdoor track, escorted by head coach Christopher McCoy. On the Chancellor's list with a 4.0, Rodney Griffin. On the Dean's list with a 3.5. Caroline Oaks, 3.99. Tyron Lyons and Miles George. And on the honors roll, 3.25 to 3.49, Harry Self, William Smith, LaMarcus Woodward, and Jawan Parker. And now soccer is where my entry head coach, Marcus Hooper. On the chess resistance with a 4.0, Victoria Ressler, Michaela Cowles, Carissa Fidwick, Jordan Noor, Kelsey Martin, Veronica Parker, and Anna Silverio. On the knees list, 3.5 to 3.99, Maria Rios John, Tyler Babb, Gabriella Yamara, Jessica Cota, Sarah Wright, Sierra Fidwick, Maria Abrude Campos, Saria Orochu, Crystal Ruiz, and Haley Russell. And on the honors roll, 3.25 to 3.49, Shannon Seymour and Rebecca Holmes. And now, ladies and gentlemen, softball is led by head coach Kevin Montgomery. On the chances list with a 4.0, Lydia Mitchell, Maria Acuar, Morgan Carter, Sydney Crossin, Kayla Reed, Shanice Atkins, and Taylor Moody. On the Dean's list, 3.5 to 3.99, Kara Hall, Cameron Graham, Alexandria Taylor. And on the honors roll, GPAs are 3.25 to 3.49, Rihanna Young, Tanae Hawkins, and Monique Nicolau. And now, ladies and gentlemen, women's tennis has scored by head coach James Cowan. On the Dean's list with a 4.0, on the Dean's list with a 3.5 to 3.99, Jenna Lewis. And on the honor roll, Jalen Reed. And men's tennis, 4.0, Kapsol Lenwarman. Dean's list, 3.5 to 3.99, Simon Lewis, Ladarian Ledbetter, Saheed Rockman, and Jalen Craig. And now volleyball, escorted by head coach Justin Solomon. On the chances list, 4.0, Taylor Burrell, Natalie Gibbs, Haley Price, Kendall Howard, Brittany Solomon, and Jenna Wozinski. On the Dean's list, 3.5 to 3.99, Lauren Corby, Katie Huffnagel, and Talia Ross. And on the honor roll, 3.25 to 3.49, Tamara Ross. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the cheerleaders escorted by head coach Karen Lund. On the chancellor's list with a 4.0, Mark Robinson. On the dean's list with a 3.50 and a 3.99, through a 3.99, Taylor Raymond Johnson, Rachel McAfee, Karita Washington, Alexis Wheaton, and Darian Tisdale. And on the honor roll with a 3.25 to a 3.49, Sage Davis, Disney Rudds, and Amari Williams. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the marching music machine of the Mid-South and pep bands is heard by director of bands, Sean Grant. When the spring 2016 honorees were announced earlier this season, three band members were inadvertently omitted to recognize them at this time. Amber Timms on the Dean's list, Devin Brown, Dean's list also, and Leticia Portnoy. And now, here the band's fall 2016 honorees on the Chancellor's list with the 4.0. Keosha Adams, Jessica Anderson, Bobby Denise Fields, Kiara Hurst, and Inga Wardman. On the Dean's list, 3.50 to 3.99, Brianna Atkins, Demetrius Anderson, Kiara Avery, Taylor Connor, Deion Cotton-Martin, Jamar Dixon, Devin Dotson, Neva Evans, Taylor Hammond, Edward Hayes, Ashley Jackson, Melanie Jones, Kaylin Marshall, Melissa McCown, McComb, Gary Pickett, Tawn Pledger, Stacey Reed, Deshae Grover, Tamaya Strickland, Joseph Lupton Jr., Courtney White, and Andrew Williams. And on the honor roll for the band, with GPAs of 3.25 to 3.49, DJ Allen, Shekinah Anderson, Alexander, Kiara Rumble, Alexis Edwards, Dante Harris, Shakira Harrison, Dimitri Jones, Andreas Lara, Cartimion McClendon, Raven Magruder, Stephen Morris, Jay Peters, Marquise Marucci, Lakeisha Smith, Jakari St. Pierre, Kevin Stubblefield, Jadon Weathersby, Aaron Wedlow, Cedric White, Cleosha Williams, and Gabrielle Wood. Let's have a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for all of our student athletes, cheerleaders, and band members.
Back inside of H.O. Clemens Arena, just about set for the second half here. Tim Stubbs courtside. Best seat in the house, 39 all UAPB and Alcorn State. Alcorn will inbound it as we begin the second half of play. They were led in that first half by Mosby with his 12. Gold Lions led by Jaquan Lynch with 18. It's six threes. Here's Davis in the lane. Mosby almost traveled with it. 10 to shoot. Patterson, cross-court pass, hit the bottom of the rim, stolen by Steen. Just the fifth turnover by Alcorn in the game. The Gold Lions with just seven. UAPB out-rebounded Alcorn 21-12 in that first half. But Alcorn outscoring UAPB 9-0 from the foul line. UAPB has yet to attempt a free throw. Alcorn has not missed one, 9-for-9. Here's Robinson, spin move in the lane, up and under. A lot of contact, no call. Doolin gets the rebound. Only three fouls called on Alcorn in that first half, eight against UAPB. Both teams shot it well in the first half, right at 48% for both teams. Alcorn was 4 of 11 from three-point range, UAPB 7 of 16. They get it inside to Vance. He was bumped by Barry, and that's going to be Barry's second, team foul number one of the second half. The Gold Lions outscored Alcorn by 9 from the three-point line, but Alcorn outscored UAPB by 9 from the foul line to even it out. Thrown away, coming our way, and Mosby can't save it as he bumps into the Alcorn broadcast table. Here's Steen on the block. Nice move. Can't get it to go. Kept alive by Steen and saved by Robinson. Kick out to Tolliver. Rise and fire for three. It's short. Rebound Vance. 39 all, same score at halftime. Almost 2 minutes into the second half here. Three in the corner is good. Alcorn leads by three. Here's Steen on the block. Strong move, got it. Trent Steen doing work inside. Steen with 8 points. Cuts the lead to one for Alcorn. That three-point lead a moment ago for Alcorn was their largest of the game. Gold Lions' largest lead has been 10. 42-41, Braves by a point. Davis scores inside for Alcorn. They go up by three. 44-41, 17:05 to go, second half. Robinson to Lynch. And they're going to call an offensive foul on Lynch. Second team foul, and Lynch is second. Top of the key, Mosby. Right side, Patterson, ball fake, gets in the lane. They let him play through it, and he scores. I think he was thinking there was going to be a foul called, but to his credit, he kept playing through the contact. Five-point lead for Alcorn, 46-41, their largest lead of the game. McKinney and Wallace set to check in. There's Robinson on the left wing, gets it to Steen. Spin move, goes over the right hand, and scores. Nicely done, Trent Steen. And double figures now with 10. First half, they rode the shoulders of Jaquan Lynch. Second half, it may be Trent Steen. Tipped by Robinson, stolen here, Lynch. Two on two, spin move. Robinson got it. Nicely done. Big time spin move in the lane for the senior from Itabena, Mississippi. Back to a one-point game, trying to trap Vance here on the right block. The kick out by Davis to Patterson. Now they got him trapped. And a foul's gonna be called on the Golden Lions. It's gonna be on Steen. That will be his. That's his third, and that's a big foul early in the second half. Media timeout here. 15:45 to play early second half. Alcorn State 46, UAPB 45. Well, Golden Lion fans, mark your calendars for February 24th. As we will honor two UAPB sports legends, L.C. Greenwood and James Red McAllen. Our second ever ultimate honor, a jersey retirement celebration at the Robinson Center in Little Rock, with the reception beginning promptly at 6 p.m., dinner at 7 p.m. Special guest speakers, you're not going to want to miss this, include NBA Hall of Famer Willis Reed of the New York Knicks and NFL Hall of Famer Mean Joe Green of the Pittsburgh Steelers. For more information, contact the UAPB Office of Development, 870-575-8701. That's 870-575-8701. I will be emceeing that event, and it should be a very exciting night. Second ever jersey retirement ultimate honor celebration. .15:45 left. Early second half. Alcorn by one. They'll inbound it. Left side of Doolin, top of the key here. Howard. Now right side to Doolin again. Gets it to Johnson, top of the key. Johnson wants to take the three, but a whistle is called before that, and the fouls just keep piling up against UAPB. They had eight called against them in the first half, to only three for Alcorn. Well, Alcorn's yet to be called for a foul here early on the second half. UAPB with four more. Quick math says that is 12 fouls to just three for Alcorn. The steal by McKinney, trying to get it to Lynch, and off the hand of Howard out of bounds, so to stay with the Golden Lions as they had a nice two-on-one break there. They spread the floor, but Howard able to get back on defense. Golden Lions look to regain the lead. Wallace, Lynch, right side, McKinney. Back to Wallace. 10 to shoot. Here's Lynch. Pull up from 17 is good, and he stays hot. Jaquan Lynch having his best shooting night of his UAPB tenure. Puts the Golden Lions back up. Lynch has 20 in the game to lead all scorers. Here's Doolin. Pull up, long 18-footer, short. McKinney's got it for Pine Bluff. He'll push it ahead. McKinney in the lane, wants to go all the way with a left hand, blocked by Doolin, and Howard chases it down. Here come the Braves. Johnson passes at the last second to Doolin, back inside. Johnson missed it, but McKinney draws. The foul's going to be called on McKinney, rather. That'll be the fifth team foul already on UAPB in the second half. That's the second on McKinney. First shot is good. Alcorn continues to stay perfect, 10 for 10 from the foul line. .14:25 to play, second half. Tied at 47. Their first miss from the line there by Reginald Johnson. Golden Lions with the basketball. Marquise Cunningham in for the first time tonight. Lynch, McKinney, Cunningham, Harper, and Wallace. They get it inside to Harper, and that time he plays through contact and gets the kiss off the glass. UAPB back up by two. Harper's first two of the game. Go Lions have been much stronger around the basket here tonight. Partially blocked there by Harper off the Patterson drive. Golden Lions up two with the basketball here. McKinney holds it out high as they set the offense. Lynch will come out and get it. 15 on the shot clock. A screen from Cunningham. Right side, Harper thought about the shot. Pull up from 10, hits the side of the backboard, kept alive to Cunningham. Got to shoot it here. Lynch, a long three with the shot clock winding down. That actually did graze. It did graze the rim, but they missed it. They may come over here and look at it. It hit the back corner of the rim just a little bit. And they're going to award it to UAPB. If they come look at it, I think you're going to see it did hit the rim. From my vantage point, it did graze the back part of the rim. This should be Golden Lion basketball as they got the rebound and they caught a shot clock violation and they didn't even need to look at it. They huddled up together and got it right. So the Golden Lions will inbound it and get a benefit of a new shot clock. ...13-18 to play. Golden Lions up two with the basketball. McKinney tosses it in. Cunningham chases it down. Set it up here with Wallace. Out high. Top of the key now. Off the bounce. On the right block. Harper to Lynch. Strong drive. Kick out in the corner. Cunningham. Jumper is short. Rebound Davis for Alcorn. Mosby, left side of the floor to Johnson. Strong drive at good hands, poked away by Cunningham. Here's Lynch, little Euro step off the glass, no good. And they're gonna say last touch by Alcorn. The Braves did not like the call. Still a two-point lead here for UAPB, 12-35 and counting. Cunningham trying to get it to Harper. Off the bounce, Cunningham will take it himself. Gives it to, tried to get it to Wallace in traffic, turned it over. Davis wants to go all the way, scores and one. Ties it at 49 and a free throw coming up for DeAndre Davis. First on Cunningham, now six fouls on UAPB. They've had 14 fouls called against them in this game and only three against Alcorn. First shot or the tail end of the three-point play is good. Davis stays perfect from the foul line, and that puts Alcorn State up by one. 50-49, 12 and a half to play. Here's Lynch, gets it to McKinney, middle of the lane, tried to dish it to Harper, knocked away at the last second by Alcorn. McKinney will inbound it with 19 on the shot clock. Tosses it up high, gets it to Harper, the right block. Goes up strong with it, and they're going to wave it off. Wanted an and one there, but they called the foul on the floor. I like how Harper's attacking down low, however. Get it to Lynch in the corner. Now they'll set it back out high, the new shot clock. Golden Lions with the ball down one, just over 12 to play. Cunningham forces a bad pass in there as DeAndre Davis overplayed it. Gets the steal. Left side to Doolin. Kick out to Howard, right side to Mosby. Long pass to Doolin cross court. Get it to Davis, out high. Driving the lane, kick out. Mosby spots up for three and hits. Mosby gives Alcorn a four-point lead, their largest of the game. Mosby now is 17. Here's Lynch. Needs some help, he's trapped. And I think they got a timeout called. Timeout called by George Ivory as Lynch was in big trouble. Timeout on the floor. It'll be a full timeout. 11:27 to play. 53-49. Alcorn up by four. Alcorn talking it over with the officials, wanting a foul call there against UAPB, but they've had their lion's share of fouls go their way in this game, if you will. M4 Pep Band. And 27 left as we approach the midway point of the second half. The Golden Lions down by four. Lynch will bring it ahead. He had 18 first half points, just two here in the second half so far, but they're going to need more. Here's Harper back out to Jackson. Shot clock down to three. Lynch is hit, I guess you're going to say partially blocked. Looked like maybe he was fouled. They're going to call a clean block on his three-point attempt. And now 14 fouls to just four called against Alcorn. Alcorn with the basketball here, up by four, their largest lead of the game. Golden Lions led by as many as 10. Cross court pass goes into the sideline of Alcorn State out of bounds. So UAPB will get it back on Alcorn's 10th turnover of the game, matching UAPB's 10 turnovers. Jackson with the basketball, gets it to Bayless, who just checked in, back to Jackson. So we got Lynch, Tolliver, Jackson, Bayless, and Harper, the best shooting lineup here for UAPB, with Tolliver, Lynch, and Jackson all can shoot the three. Here's Bayless, lobs it inside, a tough pass there as it was a double team down low. I don't think a perfect pass would have snuck in there. Turnover gives it back to Alcorn. 53-49, Braves by four with the basketball, 10 minutes to play. Here's Mosby to Johnson, power dribble. Gonna call a block on Harper and let's see if he was shooting or not, but another foul. That's now the Oh, seventh team foul already, midway point of the second half. And the 15th total foul on UAPB. They're going to say two shots in the act of shooting. Steen set to check in for the Golden Lions. UAPB doing a great job out rebounding Alcorn State 29-13, but being outscored from the free throw line now 12-0. That's the difference in the game. As Alcorn leaves by five, even though the Golden Lions have three more field goals made. Alcorn now 12 for 13 from the foul line. They get 13 out of 14, and the Golden Lions have been left out, shut out at the foul line. Lead at six, now the largest of the game for the Braves. Here's Tolliver to Berry. Working back right side here to Lynch, to Jackson. Trying to get it down low to Steen on the right block. He's on the baseline with it, needs some help as they trap him. Off the leg of Vance out of bounds, four on the shot clock. Jackson to Lynch. Nice pass. Steen gets it to go with one on the shot clock. Beautiful find there by Lynch, and Steen the easy two. He's got 12 in the game. Much needed bucket there. 55-51, 4-point game. Vance working around here. Johnson. Left side, open three, Howard, way off to the left, no good. Steen secures it for the Golden Lions. Now to Jackson. Push it right side of the floor. Thought about taking that three there in rhythm, but he passes it up. May have had Coach Ivory in his right ear telling him otherwise, but he looked like he wanted to pull up. And Tolliver trying to get it into Steen, but good hands there. The reach around by Johnson, the steal for Alcorn. Braves with the basketball up four. Almost a travel. I guess they're going to just say it was, they touched the ball. 3-point shot. Vance, no good. Battle for the rebound, and that's going to be a foul on Reginald Johnson of Alcorn. And just their second foul call to the second half. And only their fifth team foul of the game. Nearly 32 minutes of action going by. The 15 fouls called on UAPB. Tough pass again, and another turnover. Went off the fingertips of McKinney, had to go up high for it. Got a little sloppy with the ball here in the last couple of minutes. And now Alcorn gives it right back to him off of DeAndre Davis. And out of bounds. So 8 minutes to go. Golden Lions haven't played well here in the second half, but only down four. As the clock started, but no one touched it. See if the Golden Lions can get something going here. .02 to play. Now they reset the clock. Lynch will pick it up right at midcourt. Right side to Jackson. Tipped, but to Steen on the baseline. Behind the back pass. Jackson's hammered, and he'll shoot two. The nice behind the back pass there by Steen. Jackson had a lane to the basket. Media timeout. Alcorn State leading UAPB 55-51. Still a lot of game left, but getting down to winning time here. Alcorn with a 4-point advantage.
As we celebrate the retirement journey of two of UAPB's all-time greatest athletes, Jay Allen and LC Green. Special gift for Show tickets tonight or call 870-575-8701 for more information.
55-51, 4-point lead for Alcorn. Charles Jackson is about to shoot the first free throws of the game for UAPB with 7:50 remaining in the contest. And I think I just read George Ivory's lips. I want to say he said this is our first free throws. I could be wrong, but if he didn't say it, I know he's thinking it, and Jackson misses. Alcorn 13 of 14 from the foul line, outscoring UAPB 13 to zip from the foul line. The first free throw just a moment ago by Jackson. Makes one of two. So the first free throw of the game for UAPB with 7:50 to play. Cuts it to a 3-point Alcorn lead. Gold Lions out rebounding Alcorn 32-13. Wow. Led by Trent Steen, 7 rebounds. Go along with 12 points. Pull up by Howard is good from 17 on the left wing. 57-52. Alcorn's largest lead's been 6. It's at 5 right now. McKinney. 15 to shoot to Jackson, gets it to Steen, lobs it inside, it goes to Berry, gets it to go in one. It was intended for McKinney off the deflection, went right to Berry, and he knew what to do with it. Now the Gold Lions will have another chance at the foul line here. Just the 14th foul on Alcorn. 7:04 to play. This could cut it to 2 here. Rimmed out, no good. You don't get very many opportunities. Every miss seems so critical. And an offensive foul, a charge called on Marquise Vance. 15th foul, the first on Vance. 57-54, Gold Lions will get it back down by 3 with 6:55 to play. Here's Vance, left side Jackson. Now McKinney in the corner, strong drive in the lane, up and under, sweet move by Mr. McKinney. Gets it to go, and it's a 1-point game. 57-56. Kenny's so good at controlling his body and weaving it into traffic like that. Davis with a grown man basket inside. 59-56, back to a 3-point lead for Alcorn. A little over 6 to play. Screen from Berry, Lynch still on the bounce, right side. Jackson for the tie of well short. And off the fingertips of McKinney out of bounds. Had a good look there and left it short. 5:59 to go. Gold Lions are gonna have to get some stops, become more efficient. They were much more efficient in the first half offensively. It's been a defensive struggle here in the second half. Tipped and stolen here by McKinney. McKinney, it's got to be a block. They're going to call it travel. called a travel on McKinney, but it looked like Mosby was setting up for a block or setting up for a charge, but blocked him. But nevertheless, that's the call is a travel. Sometimes the fan comes out in me a little bit. Right side, Howard, top of the key to Vance. Strong drive in the lane, throws up a wild shot, no good. Davis gets the rebound, and he's going to be fouled and shoot two. And a rare, just the second offensive rebound of the night for Alcorn. UAPB's got 13 of them. .5:13 to play, 59-56, Alcorn by three. DeAndre Davis, a 6-for-6 from the foul line tonight. He'll have two more here. First shot is good. Seven for seven. Make it 8-for-8, he gets the shooter's roll. Just over five to play. The lead at 5 here for Alcorn. Golden Lions are gonna have to turn it up down the stretch if they wanna pull this one out. Tolliver on the left wing. Jackson was open down low, but they missed him. Right side to McKinney, 7 to shoot, McKinney. Strong drive, they get it to Bayless. He's bumped and loses the basketball on a turnover. Crucial. Now Alcorn's got a gift. Right back to the Golden Lions as they throw it into the sideline. .4:40 to play, each possession so critical down the stretch. Golden Lions with the ball, just over 4.5 to go, down 5. Down low. Harper tipped, missed it. Mosby secures it. Missed opportunity there. Still a 5-point lead for Alcorn in the basketball. Stripped, stolen, Lynch. That's going to be a foul on Vance. As Golden Lions were getting ready for a breakaway there. Vance fouled him on the floor. So the Golden Lions will get it back down 5 after this media timeout with 3:55 left. There's Shelly Roby Ingram. 61-56. Alcorn by 5. The Golden Lions got some work to do. Golden Lions with the basketball as we resume play. Harper's going to be fouled and shoot two. Sorry for the delay there. The officials came over to look at something, and then after they had me cue it up, they said never mind, and all of a sudden the action was starting. So not sure what that was all about, but nevertheless, it's a Harper. Good gracious. Missed the free throw, and Golden Lions have only had a handful of attempts. These misses are big. One more coming up for Trayvon Harper. Got the second. 3:45 to go. Everything's so crucial down the stretch. 61-57. Four-point lead for Alcorn, and they have the basketball. Here's Mosby. Golden Lions need a stop here. Vance back to Mosby. It's going to go to Johnson on the right block. Kicks it back out. Mosby for three is good, and he has been hot pretty much all night. He's got 20 in the game. And the biggest lead of the game here for Alcorn with just over three to play. They're up seven, 64-57. Jackson, the shake, pull up, air ball, out of bounds. Now they changed the call. They first said Golden Lion ball. Now they say Alcorn ball. 2:56 to go. Alcorn now in control of this game. Up by seven. Here's Vance out high, picked up by Wallace. Vance will get it back here. They leave him open. Mosby this time off the left, no good. Offensive rebound, Davis. Reset the shot clock. Davis is going to be fouled. Be a 1-1 coming up here. Going to call it on McKinney. Be his third. Team foul number nine. Golden Lions only 18 second half points after 39 in the first half. Free throw is good. Now an 8-point lead. They increased their largest lead. Golden Lions led by 10 in the first half. We were tied at halftime, but Alcorn outscoring UAPB by 8. So far, the first 17 minutes of the second half make it 9 as Davis stays perfect from the line. 66-57, 2:20 to go. Golden Lions are going to have to be pretty much perfect from here on out to have a chance. Here's Wallace to McKinney. And that's not going to work right there. It's going to be a tie-up. It's going to stay with UAPB on the possession arrow. They'll inbound it. Here is Lynch. Little jump stop in the lane. Teardrop no good. Out of bounds. Last touch by Alcorn. 2:01 to play. Getting really late. And Alcorn up by 9. Top of the key here. Robinson. Now to Wallace. Needs some help to McKinney. Get it to Lynch in the corner for three. It's short, no good. And Lynch had 6 threes in the first half. Just 2 points in the second half. 66-57, Alcorn with the basketball, up 9. A minute and a half to go. Going to play them straight up here, but they're going to have to foul from here on out. Here's Howard, five on the shot clock. Vance will get the shot off. No good. Rebound, Lynch. 1:15 to go, down nine. Robinson, strong drive, contact, no call. Going to say a clean block, Alcorn on a run out here. Mosby trying to go all the way, throws up a wild shot as he hits the base of the backboard. 101 to go, and free throws coming up here for Mosby. Mosby and Davis both with 20 apiece for Alcorn State. Makes the first, and timeout called by Coach Ivory here as Alcorn State sees their lead go up to 10, matching the Golden Lions' largest lead at one point. They got away from the Golden Lions in that final few minutes. Very frustrating. We had Texas Southern next Saturday night. We'll have it for you right here on Hot 89.7. And at Prairie View next Monday night. Mosby back to the line. He's got 21 in the game. He'll shoot another here. And makes another. So the lead up to 11, just under a minute to go. Wallace to Lynch, right side, McKinney. Lynch gets it to Steen on the right block, throws it out. Wallace drives left side, contact. He's going to shoot two. Marcus Wallace looking for his first points of the game. And misses the first. One more coming up for Wallace. Just 43 seconds left. Golden Lions down now by 10 after the free throw by Wallace goes. He's on the scoreboard with 1 point. They're going to throw a home run ball down deep here. Reginald Johnson lays it in. 70-58, 12-point lead for Alcorn. And a turnover is going to give it back to the Braves, and that's going to do it here with 25 seconds left. No reason to foul at this point. 12-point ball game. They'll hold the ball with 9 seconds left. That's going to do it as coaches shake hands near midcourt. That's the ball game. Disappointing loss for the Golden Lions here tonight. Very winnable game. We've tied at halftime. And very tight back and forth throughout the second half. But Alcorn able to gut out a 70-58 win, pulling away late in this one. And the final 5 minutes down the stretch to put it away. So Alcorn State will improve now to 10-3, still in second place behind Texas Southern. The Golden Lions fall to 6-7, but depending on what Jackson State and Alabama State does, still could be tied for fourth place at the end of the night. And depending on what Prairie View does as well, they are 5-6. UAPB now 6-7. So still very tight in that four spot. And Golden Lions are trying to get in that top four to be able to host first round tournament game. But it didn't go the way of the Golden Lions tonight, as they fall 70-58, alma mater being played now by the M4 Pep Band. We'll be joined by Coach George Ivory here in just a few moments. Our crew here this evening, back in the hot 89.7 studio, Miss Alicia Dorn and Tony McCastle. Here in H.O. Clemens Arena, our crew, Randy Kelly, Shelly Roby Ingram, and Ariana Carmichael. Very limited crew here tonight, but did a very good job. Good job, guys. As we put our final touches on this one, we await Coach Ivor here in a moment. I'm also waiting on a stat sheet. They're bringing one over now. Here we go. I need two stat sheets. One. Let me get you mic'd up here. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I get.
Well, a frustrating game, frustrating loss. Let me lower your mic just a little bit, Coach. 70-58 the final, tied at 39 at halftime. Just your thoughts on tonight before we kind of get into the numbers and some of my thoughts. I want to hear from the head lion.
Well, you know, one thing about it is, you know, like I told you, you got Trent Steen, an outstanding basketball player inside, and you had Lynch really shooting the ball well, and we kind of stopped going to that. And we had some careless mistakes, you know, going down the stretch also as well. But, you know, I just think that these guys got to play through it, and Alcorn shot free throws exceptionally well. You know, they shot 20 to our 7. You know, I think that's a big description. Like I told a guy one time, it was 7-0 in foul. You know, come on, man. Both teams are playing, but not going to make any excuses.
At one point, it was 15 fouls to just 4.
Yeah.
And you didn't get your first free throw opportunity until 7 minutes to go in the game. By then, they had already outscored you 13-0 from the foul line at that point. You look at it, you had two more field goals than they did.
Yeah.
But at being outscored 19-3 from the foul line is kind of becoming a common theme over the past few games for you, Coach. And for whatever rhyme or reason, it is what it is. But it's one of those games, you look at the numbers, you shot 42%, hit 7 threes. You know, you out-rebounded them by 13. I mean, you look at the numbers and you might think the Golden Lions would have won this game. But
yeah.
Being outscored by 13 from the foul line is a huge, huge stat for sure.
Oh, yeah. When you look at, you know, 20-19 and we make 3 and don't shoot but 7, that kept them in the game and gave them the game to me, you know.
No question about it. Well, the Golden Lions tonight, 24-57 from the field, 42%. Not a bad percentage. Three-point line. You started off red hot. Boy, Jaquan Lynch was putting on a show early. Yeah. Came out, hit 5 threes. He had 6 in the first half, 18 halftime points. But
only finished with 20 for the game, but your thoughts on Jaquan's first half?
Well, I thought he shot the ball extremely well the first half. I think, you know, he's doing a great job of shooting it, but, you know, I think that we got to keep going to him the second half and getting him open and, you know, and that's one thing we didn't do tonight and came back to hunt us, you know, but, you know, we got to get back to the drawing board and get back in there and try to, you know, I guess stop fouling so much.
Steen, tonight you talked about trying to get him the ball, you know, around 15 shots a game. He was very efficient, 6 of 9, had 12 points, 7 rebounds, a couple of assists and a steal tonight in 29 minutes of action. But outside of that, and Lynch's 20, it was kind of sparse offensively tonight.
Oh, yeah. It was a bad night for it, you know. That kind of situation of scoring, our bench really didn't score well tonight. I don't know what we did.
It's usually on this stat sheet, but I don't see it on here, the bench points tonight. But just couldn't get it going in that second half for whatever reason. Had a 10-point lead in the first half. It looked good. They end up tying it at halftime, and it was anybody's game for the first 10 minutes of the second half. But this has kind of been a carbon copy of what we've seen at Grambling. Saw it at Southern. You can name several games, especially on the road, where your team was in it through the first 30 to 35 minutes of the game. But for whatever reason, around that 8 to 4 minute mark, there seems to be something that happens where the opponents go on a run and not able to close the deal. And that's what we saw here tonight.
Yeah. You know, I guess, you know, the biggest thing, we got to get the ball to playmakers to make shots. And, you know, we're taking shots that we shouldn't be taking. But, you know, we're going to get back and work at it and get ready to go on out to Texas and try to get 2 wins and come Wednesday. And so we just got to get back to the drawing board.
Still really thick. There was a 3-way tie for 4th place at 6-6 coming into this game. So even with the loss, depending on what a couple other teams did, you still may be right there tied for 4th. We'll just have to see what happens, but you're still a win or two away from third or maybe second place. Yeah. So it's still wide open.
Yeah, it's still wide open at this point, you know. But, you know, I just think that we just got to keep playing hard and keep working. And, you know, I guess we got to drive some more and get some more fouls because, man.
They're hard to come by right
what
now.
What you talking about?
For sure. Well, Coach, I'm not going to hold you up. I know a frustrating loss. I appreciate you stopping by. And we'll be ready to go to Houston. Late Thursday.
That's right.
All right. Coach George Ivory.
Okay.
Gracious enough to join us here courtside as we wrap things up. Tough loss, 70-58. As we wrap things up here from H.O. Clemens Arena. I mentioned our crew here courtside tonight. Randy Kelly, Shelby Roby Ingram. Excuse me, Shelly. Ariana Carmichael, and myself. Tim Stubbs saying so long from H.O. Clemens Arena, 70-58. Alcorn State wins it over UAPB. Until next time, good night. Go Lions.